Well, boys, welcome back to the channel, and today we're doing a long-term review on this Honda Foreman 450 right here. I know I've already done one review on it, and it absolutely exploded, guys. You guys loved that video so much, so I decided, why not make one more video about it, a long-term review, because we've had it for a while now, and used it a lot, abused it, had fun with it, and yeah, let's hop right into it. I'm going
job well done. So I step to the edge and I take a deep breath. I'm not turning back around, 'cause there's no turning back now. I'm going all in, head first to the deep end.
So, as I said earlier, this here is a Honda Foreman 450 ES. It is the 2004 model, so the newest model they made this specific four-wheeler. And it's just amazing, guys. Obviously, it comes with the Honda Legacy, which is just an unbreakable, unbeatable four-wheeler. Not saying that it's super overpowered and insanely fast, but that it is just the right amount of power and is literally the most durable and just bulletproof engine I've ever seen, guys. It's an amazing, amazing engine. And yeah, I absolutely love it, guys. It's a super fun four-wheeler to ride, even after almost a year of owning it. It's just been an amazing, amazing four-wheeler. And yeah, first let's get into a few of the things I've done to this one, and then we'll talk about all the other stuff about it. But the only things I've done to it pretty much are, well, not that I personally did this, but right down there are new tires. I don't even know what the stock tires are that come with this, but this has 26-inch, or I think they're 26s. Okay, yeah, they're 26-inch ITP Mudlite tires, and they're amazing, guys. Love ITP, love Mudlites. They're a great tire. They fit on here nice, the 26s do. Although I do kind of want to get a bigger tire, like maybe 27s, 28s, which I don't know if they'd quite clear right now, so I'm thinking also maybe getting a 2-inch lift. It'll also help with tires, but it's also a great idea if you want a little bit more ground clearance, because if you could see, I have this Yamaha Grizzly 700 sitting right next to us, and it sits way higher than this, like way higher. It's got about 11, and with the new tires, probably 12 inches of ground clearance, maybe 13. This probably sitting at, I have no clue, but it sits pretty low to the ground, so you can get bottomed out kind of easy, which is pretty much its main problem. Like, it has enough power to go through a lot of stuff, and if you have nice tires, that really helps, but it just needs a little bit more ground clearance, so a little lift would definitely help with that. So yeah, we've done tires. We have a winch on here, which is half working right now. We need some new fuses for it. But yeah, we have a winch on here. We have heated hand grips and thumb grips, which is amazing, guys. They work so well, and it's just so nice to have them when it's cold out. If you don't live somewhere cold, maybe I wouldn't get it. But here in Minnesota, where it gets down to like negative 30 in the winter, it's definitely nice to have them. What else have we done? I have this little phone mount on here, so I can hold my phone on here, so then I can see what I'm doing, which is nice until you get it wet and then you get your phone all wet, but yeah, I think it's nice. I had underglow on here, but they stopped working, so the underglow is now out of commission. I actually cut the line, so the line that has all the lights on it actually snapped, so yeah, underglow is kind of out of commission. What else have we done with it? We did carb work right when we got it, and that cleared up almost all the problems. It didn't like to run, it kind of got boggy. And after doing carb work, completely cleared up the problems, runs perfect now. But the only other thing I would say, and it's a big thing to me, is electric shift. It's a good idea, but if you're going through deep water or if you're getting anything, any of the electronics wet, maybe not, because they sometimes do like to glitch and just not work if they get wet or super cold or anything like that. So that's, I mean, like, I'm fine with it, and if I had to get another Honda, I would, and I would also be fine with electric shift. But if I could, I would rather look for an automatic, because it's just the better, it's less stuff to go wrong. So yeah, that's one of my only problems. But Yeah, other things, it doesn't go through a lot of gas. It's got a kind of small gas tank, but it doesn't go through a lot of gas, so that's not that bad. How many miles have I put on this? So if I look on here, it has 3,800 miles on here, and I bought it with, how many? Maybe 2,400 miles, 2,800 miles. So I put over 1,000 miles on this thing, and it handles great, guys. And it just performs great. It's just a great four-wheeler. Now, it tops out around 55 miles an hour, maybe 60, but I haven't got to 60, I've gotten to 55. So not super fast, but that's as fast as I need to go. The only thing I would say is more power to spin the tires in the mud. That's my one thing. Like, I don't care about going super fast. The Grizzly right here can do that, but I just want a little bit more power so I could spin the tires a little faster. But if you do have to settle for this, and I have it right now, and I'm completely happy with it. It runs great, it'll still go through mud, and yeah, I mean, it's just if it had a little more power, that'd be nice. But yeah, it's held up great. Everything on it, all the plastics are fine. All of the stickers on here, guys, have stayed on perfectly fine. Like, I have all my stickers on here with maybe a few scratches on them, but they're not peeling, nothing. I have aftermarket stickers all around this just because I like it. And then, yeah, all the plastics have stayed on perfectly fine. It is really muddy right now. I'm sorry for that. We have taken it on a lot of rides, and it just keeps getting dirty. I've washed it like 3 times in the last month, and it still just keeps getting dirty. So, yeah, sorry, it's not really clean. But yeah, everything's held up great on the plastic side, suspension, all that stuff still holds up great. The only thing is the rear brakes here are non-existent, probably just because something on this one, but the cable's all like kind of knotted up, or not really knotted up, but just like all kinked, so the brakes don't work at all, so I just have to use my front brakes. So that's a little sad, but we'll have to fix that at some point. And then the other thing is, Honda still use drum brakes on these, which I don't agree with at all. Disc brakes are so much better. So we actually did a switch to disc brakes in the front of this, but this still has a rear, drum brake, but front disc brakes. So I'd rather have disc brakes. So if you buy it, maybe you're gonna want to put disc brakes on it. But yeah, I don't really remember the horsepower numbers. I did say that in my other review, which was, that had more of the specifications and like specs about this four-wheeler. This is just kind of talking about the durability and how it's held up. So yeah, great four-wheeler, held up great. But if you want to see all the spec stuff, go check out my other review on it. If you just go to my most viewed videos, you'll find it pretty much right at the top. So yeah, great video. That's pretty much all I have to say, guys. Held up great, great four-wheeler. I would still buy another one if I needed to. But yeah, if you're looking for something more power, if you're really looking to go through a lot of mud, maybe you want to look to something like Grizzly 6 or 700 gear. But if you don't have that kind of money, if you're just looking for something to cruise around on, maybe the farm, still go through some mud if you want, because it still can. But this is a great option for that. And yeah, I hope this helped you guys. It wasn't super long, but hope it was informative. And yeah, we'll see you guys on the next video. I'm going all